Brexit, COVID, drip. Just three buzzwords of popular culture today. Want one more? Climate change. In recent years, tighter emissions regulations have forced car manufacturers across the board to discontinue their smaller, lower volume, niche cars, resulting in a lower net CO2 figure. But back in the 2000s, four-seat, heavy, style-over-substance small cars were as acceptable as tan chinos and a Rihanna top. Volvo's entry to the market in 2007 saw middle-class parents breathe a sigh of relief as finally there was a small, youthful Volvo for their offspring that was still safe, sturdy, and reliable. But what about the sons and daughters of these middle-aged Volvo owners? Jackson and Penelope can't just drive any old car. God no. Over 15 years since its launch, the C30's interior has remained pretty timeless, with only the Bernophone style keypad making it feel old, plus the rather ill-suited handbrake overshadowing an otherwise contemporary design. For the most part, the interior is very good. The trademark floating centre console still impresses, and all models get climate control and electric heated mirrors as standard. You can also get a pop-up colour screen for your sat-nav, but as you can imagine by now, the graphics will have become a little bit long in the tooth. Well, here in the back is where we realise that the C30 is more of a fashion statement than a practical family hatch. Well, of course it is. It's a two-door, stylish, coupe-like car. What were you expecting? It's a strict four-seater in the back of the C30, which means that Jackson and Penelope, if they're sharing the car at least, can only bring one friend each back from their shopping trip at Cheshire Oaks. But when you're in the back, I mean, I suppose depending on how tall you are, I'm 6 foot, I've still got plenty of headroom, and leg room, well, it's not the best, but it's okay. The boot isn't much cop either, and as you can see, the parcel shelf is impossible. You can get the C30 with a 1.6 litre petrol engine, a 2 litre petrol engine, or a 2 litre diesel. I'm in the 2 litre diesel, and while it wins in the economy stakes, it doesn't really win in boosting the C30's youthful appearance. When it comes to actual driving, the C30 fares well. The steering and gearbox are very responsive, and handling and performance are all going to be enough for people that don't want to go too mad. But for a more advanced driving experience, think Volkswagen Scirocco. And for an even more advanced driving experience, you can't go wrong with the original Volkswagen Golf. So is the C30 a good used car buy? Well, in terms of it being a Volvo, of course it is. It's safe, it's reliable. This one's done over 150,000 miles and the steering and gearbox feel as tight as a drum, not to mention the engine. But should you buy one? Well, it gives enough driving pleasure for most people's needs. It's not very practical, but as a fashion statement, I still think the Volvo C30 is impressive enough today.